Yo guys, what's going on? I'm excited to bring you guys back. Week 2 of the UCL match here against the Carolina Caldeos. I am Pittsburgh Pichu's coach, Double N. If you guys can give the video a thumbs up, that would mean a lot to me. Go check out Jay's side of this match. It's probably going to be cooler than mine because Jay's black. And who doesn't like someone as dark charcoal as him? But fun story about this match. Actually, it's got a story behind it. Jay could not battle anytime during this week. You know, Jay just straight up just could not battle anytime during this week. He couldn't, and it sucked a lot, but he just straight up quit. Like, the only time we could have the match is today, the 26th, is the only time that we actually could have this match, you know, because Jay's gonna be out of town all week. So I did not prepare. I just brought whatever, and the only thing that I knew that was actually on his team was the Victini and the Sylveon. Otherwise, I didn't even know what was on this man's team. I didn't get to prepare to go check his side of the match against Twit. I didn't go check to see that. I unfortunately was not able to prepare at all, and you're gonna see that as it's gonna affect me inside of this match. But here we go. So I'm gonna open out with my Beedrill as he opens out with Victini. I'm gonna Mega Evolve and just protect to get the speed off. That way that I'll have the speed guaranteed in the future. You know, just to be safe, so I don't have to do some risky shit and be like, oh man, my Beedrill died because the speed didn't transfer over next turn. So he's gonna go over to Psychic, and I'm assuming that he's scarfed, but he just swaps out just like that. So at first, it made me seem like he wasn't scarfed, but I'm fairly confident that he's scarfed. So I'm gonna get out of here, go out into my Latios. Funny story about this as well, he timed out. He did not stay in predicting me to predict the Sylveon. He actually told me that he just timed out. He straight up timed out, the time ran out, he didn't click his move, and it just, God was on his side and gave him Dragon Tail. So, that sucks, but he's gonna whip me out of here. Did like 75% out to the Electros, knockoff, here I go, doesn't pop the sub, super unfortunate. So, did not expect the sub at all, I really did not expect the sub at all, you know? So, I'm gonna Flash Cannon here. I removed Acid Spray for Flash Cannon very last minute just for his Sylveon, but at the end of the day, doesn't fucking matter. I mean, still a poison move, still super effective, but still drops. I don't even know why I did that, but I did it. I'm gonna get Dragon Tail out here to my Keldeo. I'm gonna go for the Icy Wind because I don't know what else is on his team. Just in case he wanted to bring in the, just in case he didn't want to bring anything. But looking at his team now, maybe just in case he wanted to bring in the Electabuzz. But then I have Scald, so I don't honestly know why Icy Wind it. But I did. So I'm going to get out of here, though, and come out to my Entei. As he's probably going to Hyper Voice or something like that. As he actually just withdraws, makes an amazing double switch, and goes right out to Zygarde. So Jay brings everything that's really defensive, really bulky, and it's just as really... He's playing super, super cautious, you know? Just, you ever like fight a player to where you just cannot predict him? I feel like that was me and Jay. I couldn't predict Jay absolutely at all. Like, he goes for the sub here after I thought maybe he Earthquake, but he doesn't. So I gotta get out of here now and go out to my Rhyperior, which does no roar. So, yeah, as he goes for the Dragon Tail here, caught me really off guard. Maybe I thought they'd want to set up, but now that I've just confirmed this into his defensive, looking at the HP from what he's taking from my mons, that he's just not setting up at all. As I know that an adaptability boosted U-turn, even if it's resisted, even if he's physically defensive, will still be able to pop the sub. So I'm going to U-turn just to pop that sub and get out of here. And I'm going to go out into my Keldeo. Now, the weirdest thing happens here. I fought Zygarde 10 times in my life, and I've never seen a Glare Zygarde. I did not even know that it could learn Glare. So... mini clap for Jay there. I did that. That was huge because now that I can't outspeed his Electabuzz, can't outspeed Victini, can't outspeed Sneasel. Just I can't outspeed a lot now. As he goes out here into the Peekaboo to Sylveon, this thing is the bane of my existence. This blue waffle ribbon thing just doesn't want to get burned. It really just doesn't. I'm gonna get out of here though. Go out to my Entei. Or is this any move that he wants to give me? As he does a weird play here, doesn't even Hyper Voice. Just goes for the Wish. So. Goes to the Wish. He's really healthy, so maybe he's trying to pass the Wish on to a Zygarde, you know? That's what I'm thinking. That's what you guys are probably thinking as well. No, he stays in and protects, so I don't understand. Maybe he just did that to try and get his Sylveon back up to full HP, but otherwise, that play just really just confused me, because it was like, you have a Zygarde chilling right there, but even a Victini that you could have just came in full HP, even a Golbat, but No, I'm just gonna sacrifice here though. Hopefully I get the 50% to burn. And for the first time in my life, ladies and gentlemen, in my Auris life, I actually got a burn with Sacred Fire. It sounds crazy, I know, it's a coin flip, 50%, but I always get the 50% that never burns. But I was able to burn it, so I'm gonna get out of here, go up to Kyoto, expecting the glare again, which does do that. Awesome stuff to me, mate. And now I could just go for a Scald here. So I am chilling really good. I mean, if he goes out to Sylveon, that's great. Because at this point, I did not care if he went out to Sylveon. I did not want to predict it. Only because of the fact that I can burn with Scald, right? Again, no burn. That's like the third Scald that I've gone for. And no burn at all. 30% my actual ass, dude. I'm going to get out of here, though. Go right back out to Entei. Pretty repetitive. I've been playing really safe as well. Because at this point, like when I was playing this live, I just did not know what the fuck he had on his team. I just did not know at all. Outside of this, Zygarde, and I just didn't know because I didn't write shit down even when I was doing this live. So that's how you know. I just was not prepped. But I figured that, you know, Choice Band, Adamant, Flare Blitz just blows back his entire team. We did the calculations, 91 max on a Sylveon. So yeah, he's going to come into the Victini. I was like, whoa, Jay, you want to appreciate that Flare Blitz? And I don't think that he does. As you can see, it's a guaranteed 2 KO, even having 100 base stats all across the board and being resisted. So don't sleep on this Entei. Do not. But now he's going to come out here to a Zygarde, as I'm just going to switch out and go out into my Latios. I expected him to maybe go for the Psychic so that he'd be locked in on that, but he actually just goes right back out to the Zygarde. If anything, maybe I was going to sack off this Latios, but no, he just goes to the Zygarde. As here, I kind of expected this thing to come in, so I am indeed just going to go for the Psy Shock. As you can see from that roll, if I do get a high roll, it does take out the Sylveon. I calculated and everything. He's a bold Sylveon, and I did expect him to be bold from that roll. So I was like, all right, okay, cool. If I get a high roll, he dies, right? Wrong. I get a minimum roll, he lives, and gets the Wish Elf. I almost shot myself to death when that happened. I promise you. Like, I almost... Oh, my God, dude. I was aggressively rubbing hand sanitizer on my hands, dude. That's how bad it was. My luck is awful. It's really bad. Trust me, it's really bad. I got a low roll in that. Made me upset. You know, even with the physically defensive bold Sylveon, that Psy Shock would have done a lot. And at this point, I did not know he had Sneasel, so me going for the Psy Shock, being afraid of the Sneasel, I did not know. Had I have known, I probably would have surfed, changed it up and gone for like Thunderbolt, because I was packing Thunderbolt. But there it is. Just there it is, dude. Just there it is. Not a Thunderbolt. Hidden Power of Fire. What the hell is wrong with me? Hidden Power of Fire I was packing. He's going to go out to his Peekaboo, though. So just that showed me that he's not running Aerials to counter up my Keldeo. I'm like, all right, you can get a burn this time, right? No, it still just does not burn the Sylveon. It just doesn't burn at all. So I'm going to get out of here, go out to Entei. Horribly repetitive. I just keep this process going over and over and over. Here he's probably going to go over the Hyper Voids because I feel like he's just getting tired of me doing that, but he just does not. He just wishes again. The purpose of this Sylveon is to come in, wish, get itself back up to full HP, and then get the fuck back out. Like, I actually hate Sylveon with a burning passion. Like, I know some people have this Pokemon as their mascot, so I'm just sitting there like, why? Why? It's just ribbons. But, yeah, this Sylveon is literally back at full HP, and I was sad. Now, I was like, why do you still have this Zygarde alive? I was really confused. I was like, is there a purpose? Are you trying to wish pass? But maybe he's trying to glare my Mega Beedrill, you know? I don't know. He kept it around for a long time. Didn't make any sense to me at all. I'm going to get out of here. Go out to my Rhyperior. I'm going to go out to this thing. Okay. And he's going to Thunderbolt, and I'm AV, so I eat this up, right? So he's going to land a Focus Blast, and I'm like, okay, fuck my life. He actually lands a Focus Blast, but I can't burn with Scald. So you got a Special Defense drop as well, too. And I'm like, you know what? Life is great right now. And I'm like, all right, if he misses this Focus Blast, I can kill with the Flamethrower. I die. I almost cried. I didn't even almost cry. I did cry at this point. Like, just the unfortunate stuff that's happening to me is just... it's just awful, dude. It's awful. He's going to go out to Dark Knight, though, which is this thing. Expected it, so I'm going to U-turn. I forgot to change Drill Run. I have Drill Run over Knockoff, so I actually can't even touch this thing, and I straight up just forgot to change it. You know, I forgot to change dribbling for knockoffs. I could touch this thing, but unfortunately, I cannot do shit. So he's gonna go to Electabuzz. I'm a rock blast. No, I'm gonna put up the rocks. All right, I'm like, cool, free rocks. Withers down the Victini, the Sneasel, the Golbat. I'm good, right? He's gonna HP. I'm assuming it's HP grass, because look at that damage. That's HP grass damage. I'm just gonna go for the Earthquake and take it out. Psych, HP grass is times four, it's HP ice. I was gonna say, like, HP grass, I don't even know what the fuck HP that is, but I'm looking at that roll, I'm assuming that it's HP ice, because HP grass, a little bit more. He's gonna low kick though, which is fine by me. That can just take me out. It's fine, you know, it's honestly fine. As I'm just gonna go out to Ponyo here, and I'm just gonna go for the skull. It's the only thing that I can do right now. He keeps bringing in this thing on my Keldeo, and I'm just like, Keldeo, for the love of Christ, burn this thing, Keldeo. But you get paralyzed. I swear to God, dude, it's like God's watching me and just doesn't want me to win. He just doesn't. As I'm gonna go out to my Entei here now, he's guaranteed to go for the Hyper Voice. He's at full HP, he has no reason not to, and he does. Had he actually gone for the Wish, I think I would have grabbed the nearest pencil and shoved it up my nose, but no, he's chilling, as he's gonna protect to see what I'm gonna lock myself into. I have to Sacred Fire to keep the thing around. The recoil will indeed take me out, and it will not kill a Bold Sylveon from max HP, unless I get a crit. Otherwise, it does 91 max, so it doesn't kill. He's gonna go up to the Sneasel's Death Fodder, and I'm like, all right, please don't miss the Sacred Fire, because it's 95% accuracy, not 100, and I've missed it a lot. So I do land it. There goes the Sneasel. He's gonna bring out the blah, 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 which is the Victini. As I do the dumbest play ever here, I go out into my Keldeo to sack it. I don't know what the fuck was in my head, but I just went out to the Keldeo to sack it. Because, like, now seeing that I could live a psychic, I was like, bro, what the hell is wrong? I choked here. Trust me, everything just gets worse here. You're gonna see, all right? Right here, I'm thinking, all right, if I extreme speed, he can go out to Golbat and preserve this thing. So Jay's gonna go out to Golbat. But I was just like, you know what? It's just been bad enough. Fuck it, YOLO. As I do extreme speed, he doesn't go to Golbat. I was like, oh okay. All right, okay. Well, okay. I'm gonna go out here into Golbat. I only have Entei and Golbat left. And picture this, he has Golbat and Sylveon left. Shit is very, very close. I could win this game. He misses a Super Fang. I was screaming. Look at the poison jab damage. Look at it. It's not that bad. For some reason, he doesn't even go for Brave Bird. I was like, bro, what are you doing? And I fuck up here a lot. Like, actually, now watching this match, it stresses me out. I should have gone out to Entei on the Roost, and then I could have just sacked my Entei on the Golbat and then bring out the Beedrill on the Sylveon. That would have been way safer to do instead of actually withering down my Beedrill and letting the thing get Roosts off. And I can't draw one when he Roosts because I'm faster than it, you know? So I choked here. As you can clearly see, I choked. I should have just gone into the Entei. And what made me even more upset, I'm like, Jay, you really just stalled this match. You had Brave Bird this entire time. This nigga. But Entei is Entei against the world. Because after this, when I realized this, I'm like, okay, Entei still one-shots this. I can live the recoil. And I one-shot Sylveon. And I one-shot Sylveon from the range it's gonna be after when it comes in on rocks. I one-shot it, all right? So I was like, shit's looking good. Shit's looking really, really good, you know? Shit's looking really good. He's gonna protect, and I'm like, okay. So it's fine, you know, it's cool, it's chill, all right? He gets the lefties, looking at that. If I get a high roll, I kill. So I have Flare Blitz, and as you can see, no high roll. So, rolls have just not really been in my favor. They really haven't. What made me upset is the Beedrill and Entei play. Should have gone out to Entei on the Roost. That way that I could have Flare Blitzed that. Flare Blitzed the Sylveon again. And then I could have just gone out to Beedrill and killed it with a Poison Jab. So I did fuck up. And I guess, unfortunately, I did not come prepared. I didn't write down Jay's team. I didn't even screen cap when we had the match. So, sloppy work here this week from the Pittsburgh Peaches. But it's not too bad. 1-1. Not a bad score. Still early, so a loss really doesn't mean anything to me. But if you guys can give the video a thumbs up, it means a lot to me. Check out Jay's perspective of it. I know I will, because I want to see. I want to see the look on his face when he absolutely just the glare. The glare moment is real. But that's going to be it. So unfortunate loss to the Pittsburgh Pichus. But we will do better next week against the Manchester Magnazones. And yeah, thank you guys for the support. I will catch you later.